Hey everybody, this is LEGO's Deep Sea Bounty set from the year 1997. Now this was from the town theme, or the equivalent of today's city, and it was a sub-theme called Divers, very similar to the most recent Deep Sea Explorers sub-theme of city. This featured this medium small-sized tender boat, which has a pretty nice level of detail on it with the printed flags up top. You know, this is a pretty tall crane rig here. Also some lights that could be turned around and angled. That actually uses a telephone handset piece on the back of that. It's just clipped into a clip and it allows you to adjust the angles in a couple of axes. This is a pretty straightforward setup for the crane itself, but it works really well because it allows you to have a working winch, which is over here, actually forms part of the base, and you can also move your cargo in and out using the boom, so the guy can be brought up and down. And you can also kind of bring this in closer to you like this pretty easily. You can also move it farther out, so that works well. And this is just a diving cage over here. It has one guy in there, and I'll show you all the figures later on. The aft deck is completely open on one side, where from the other side it looked all closed up, like you had a proper kind of superstructure cabin to the thing. But I like this X-ray table here. This is a transparent blue panel piece that goes over the top of it, and that's a print. The thing that says X-ray there, you can open this up, and that's another printed tile here, and here's yet another printed tile. I liked these. There's a whole series of these. This one's showing the insides of a seahorse, and then the other one has what appears to be an eel. That's what they're looking at there. These are just a little bit faded out. You'll see a number of parts in this set that are fairly worn down because this was well used when I got it. Printed console piece back there. This actually has a sticker on it, so that number there is a sticker, and then this flag piece has a sticker, which is supposed to be not representing a flag in particular. I think it's more like a clipboard, or is it a table or something? I think it's a clipboard, but it's like it's showing the layout of the diving site down below. I don't know if it's supposed to be a screen. I don't think that something this thin was supposed to be a screen at that time. You can put a flotation device over the railing there. You got an antenna over on this side, and then a bunch of things on a rack on this side as well, with a fishing pole. No small fish were included with this particular set that you could catch, but still it's appropriate for the theme, and then some tools as well. That macaw there is actually in phenomenal shape, but it didn't come in this used set. It came in the original, but it was actually missing from this used one, so I inserted one from my own collection, which is why that one is in such great condition. But that is the period appropriate one when they did them painted rather, or printed rather than just having the dual molding that they use nowadays. The set included a small diving utility vehicle, which is just kind of a scooter. A diver could hang on to the back of it, and you could carry some cargo around in this. It has lights on the front, and the idea is that you would find treasures and things and actually bring them up to the surface with the help of this, and you could store this just on the side over here with a little small platform off to the side, which had a jumper, which is now sticking there. Another thing that could be used with this was another vehicle, another submersible included in the set. That's this relatively big sub here, and unfortunately the front of this one is kind of lacking in friction just from age, but you can see that it was a little bit difficult to actually work this with this boat with its size. It just, you know, you're just able to get the boom out there enough, but unless you were actually at the edge of water or you had some kind of a shelf set up here where you could lower this down to a lower level, it was just a little bit unwieldy to actually get this to work around there. Also, there was no real good place to store the submersible itself on the deck, so there's no room in particular for that. And maybe you could find a way to make it kind of stay there, but didn't work out all that well. The submersible itself, I think, was perfectly fine though. Actually, quite nice for its size and the number of parts included in it. Uses stickers has a nice range of different colors, including the use of the red propeller. I think that was really smart. That's something that I personally never would have done. Like if I was trying to make this as a mock from scratch, I would not have chosen red, but I think that adds a lot of personality to the series, you know, just bringing in something a little bit different. Camera over here on the side, and or light emitter, another camera over on the other side. Maybe this is supposed to be a video recorder, and then that's just a photo recorder. And you know, you already saw that the canopy comes down towards the front, and just had a couple of control levers inside of it. You know, big old bubble canopy, so you can always see the character. I think that was really what you wanted to see, or what I certainly would have wanted to see as a kid. Lights up above. This is the bar for lifting the thing. Like I said, I think it's good for its size. And then there was also this dinghy with a outboard motor, small little outboard build. There wasn't any really good way to get the figure to pose up to really be holding on to the tiller properly, but I think that the build of this looks fine. And interestingly, they also included a couple of oars. So if you didn't want to use that outboard, you can use these instead. But here's the biggest build in this set. It's the entire seabed area, little section of the explorable space in imagination that you could go through in this entire theme. Has a very large skeleton down on the base of the seabed, which was a fun little build with a little bit of action feature in it, because in the mouth of it is a treasure chest. I guess that it ate the treasure chest and maybe it choked on it, and maybe that's why it ended up dying. It's kind of sad, but it's set up as a trap. So if this diver comes along and just tries to get at that and gets too rough with it, or just tries to get in there and push it out of the mouth, that's not very good for him, because, or let's say he kicks it out, he's gonna get eaten by the thing. It just has a simple mouse trap device in there. This is putting pressure from the top. It's putting pressure on this movable little lock. You see how that wants to slide forward? So the chest is just stopping it right there. And if you push it out of the way, then the lock is able to move. It's just sitting there. It's just gliding across the top. It's a really good little mechanism. And I think that the entire skeleton is a pretty good look. They have a little bit of variance to it. Have some, you know, fin areas, rib cage, and then also big old fin out at the back. I've got some undersea foliage around here. You could imagine that to be coral, but I think it's supposed to represent seaweed, which wouldn't necessarily be like this on the seabed. There's not enough light for photosynthesis, just saying, but hey, it's all good. I actually think it looks really good. Those are stickers on the large rock pieces, kind of preformed rock pieces. This came with a manta, or a ray, I should say, just a ray in black. I don't know exactly what type of ray it's supposed to be. This is nice what they did with the chain holding up the net there, just representing, you know, an old piece from a fishing boat, or maybe part of the lift of an old ship that went down. Came with a black octopus with the glowing kind of day glow eyes. They don't glow at night, but they appear to be very bright during the day. Another sticker there. I especially like these pieces with the transparent green. You know, lets some light through, gives it some I don't know, just kind of magical feeling. It also makes it feel a little bit more real to me. Turning this around the back, this was very interesting to me when I built this and saw that they had used the interior spaces of these large preformed rock pieces to represent kind of like caves, which I think is perfect. As a matter of fact, when I was reviewing one of the more recent LEGO City deep sea diving theme sets, I just spontaneously turned around one of them that had this kind of a rock face on it and said, well, this is unfortunate. That one didn't have anything on the inside at all. It was just like this. I said, you know, this is unfortunate that they have to use these big preformed pieces that are relatively limited in their use. They're good for what they are, but kids could come through and pretend that these are explorable spaces, that you could find stuff in there. And now here with this old set from 97, it's not that old, but it's kind of old, you know, they've done exactly that. So Lego, good job actually making use of the bad side of some parts. Some treasure to be found here. A couple of knives in there, a goblet, and some of those old chrome gold coins. The other one, the chest that was in the mouth of the creature that had died. This one has in it, that's supposed to represent some sort of totem or an old doll or something, just inside of it. And then this barrel over here, there's a goblet here, there's a barrel. This has an old sword in it, old cutlass, something like that. Yeah, nice explorable space. I'm glad that they spaced this forward a little bit as well. Makes it feel more natural to go back there and use that area and to play in it. It's nice. It's pretty large. You can put multiple figures around here. And I think it's done pretty nicely. Here are two other sea creatures also included with the set. The old dark gray shark with the articulating head that can open and close. And then this is pretty much the same thing in light gray, but with a different headpiece. It's supposed to represent a sawfish. Maybe not the most realistic, but I really liked these and still do like them. Just the variation that it presents to a scene. With all of the marine life posed up, it starts to become a fairly crowded looking area. It looks like there's just a ton of life going on and really makes it look like a very dangerous place to go swimming and exploring. Here are three of the five figures in the set. Actually, when I took off the flotation device from the guy in the middle, I was treated to a little bit of an unexpected and unwelcome surprise. He had this torso on, which was not the right one. So I fortunately was able to replace that with a torso that I still had from one of these sets that I bought back when they were still on shelves at the end of the 90s or the or 2000, I think was at the very latest. I think it was 99. But yeah, two of these had the same face and torso, and then one of them has the suit, the torso print that's shared with the divers and had a different face. Yeah, these, you know, well used, obviously, kind of beaten up, no prints on the backs of them. I like those little cameras in yellow. They made those in black as well, but yellow was something a little extra special, meant underwater capable. And here are the two fully suited up divers, and they have the same face between the two of them. Trans dark blue colored snorkel slash visor there, and white air tank on the back. These are pretty cool. I also like that white air tank. It's just something a little bit different rather than just doing the normal black or gray. Yeah, I think those were probably the most popular and easy colors to do, but this brought in just a little something different. The set also included two spear guns, although the one that I got didn't have those at all, so just another casualty of BrickLink there, unfortunately. But I substituted in just a couple of my own more recent ones in black, but they used the exact same mold, but imagine these in just regular red. And then also this one small individual diver propulsion vehicle that could be used with a single figure. It's mostly just one piece, and then they put a trans yellow stud on the front. Last up, I was fortunate enough to get the original instruction book with this, which has a very nice looking scene, although it's not the most realistic thing given that this boat does not float. Interestingly, that one does actually float, but this one does not, so I'm sure the box had something on it somewhere saying not models don't necessarily float, or model does not float, or something like that. But this is more important to me. The back, when they still showed you alternate builds. None of these use all the parts or anything, or even close, but some very different scenes, different ways of organizing things, using some of the parts from the boat. You know, the main boat here, this makes more of a smaller, tender barge, and a little bit of a lower scene there. That actually makes sense. If you set this up with an imaginary waterline, you could place your barge or tender on the top of the rock formation there, if it's small enough, the boat's small enough. That works out. And just a different way of arranging the seabed area. Cool. Deep Sea Bounty from 1997. A pretty nice playset with plenty of figures to engage in many different types of activities above and below the water. I only wish this had come with some form of stand, some mechanism to hold the boat up so you could actually lower the diver down, or if you were actually able to get the thing to float so you could use it in the water. I also wish there was just a little bit more deck space on that boat to allow you to bring up the submersible and actually hold it there. Otherwise, there's just lots and lots of stuff to have fun with and plenty of opportunity to customize and change up your adventure. Share what you think about this set by leaving a comment down below. Thanks in advance for your feedback. I'll talk to you again soon.